Hi there, it's Ron Gula from Gula Tech Adventures, and today we are going to discuss some bad cyber analogies. Now, I've had the chance to be in cybersecurity for a good bit. Used to be at the National Security Agency, ran Tenable Network Security, now I run Gula Tech Adventures. And all throughout my career, I've seen all sorts of analogies used to describe various concepts in cybersecurity. And although this is an important thing, you know, it's hard to reach people who are outside of our industry. I've always kind of had some pet peeves about different types of symbology and analogies we use. The first one is, of course, cybersecurity is like a lock and key, right? You need to have a key to open a lock, and this is what we use for controlling passwords. And in 2023, this is getting really, really old because now we have two-factor authentication, we have biometrics, we have the concept of using our phone, but I still see people use this. And it can be confusing to people who think that the password is a key and only people with that password can get in. Of course, somebody else can have, you know, a copy of that key, but there are so many other vulnerabilities in software these days. Passwords are might be the most secure part of that process. Now, another thing that's fairly interesting I hear instant responders talk about is this sort of cat and mouse chess game of hackers and defenders. And, you know, I've never really liked this either because, you know, the defender has to defend the entire chessboard and the attacker just has to find, you know, one weakness to get through. It's not like an equal set of armies who are going back and forth. There certainly can be some attack and counterattack. Maybe a hacker broke in, you patched something and, you know, they're going to come in with a different patch, but it's certainly not a battle of wits where you can see the other people. A lot of times, majority of times when people are compromised, they don't even know they're compromised. They don't even know they're playing the game. So I've never really liked this analogy, unless you're really talking about going after like nation state versus nation state and that sort of thing. Now, of course, we all learned about firewalls back when we were started about internet security before we had the term cybersecurity. You know, we talked about layers of defenses, right? You know, firewalls, patching, it's just like a moat and a portcullis, drawbridge, that sort of thing. But today, I don't think it holds up. Of course, we have layers of defense, but the concept of a single point protecting your network anymore is a very, very, very dated concept. We, of course, we have layers, we have onions, the layers of defenses and whatnot. But the reality is most people who live behind our security go out to the internet and bring the bad things with them through phishing, through clicking on links, through downloading malware and so on. So, you know, it's an interesting analogy saying the internet security is a lot like a firewall with layer defenses. But again, the concept of the perimeter is really gone by the wayside. And it's also a very dated concept in 2023. Now, one of my very favorites is people say the only secure computer in the world is one that you turn off, you put in concrete and you bury it at the bottom of a hole. That's called a denial of service attack. So I've always felt like that was a bad example. And it gives people sort of this sense of hopelessness that can really get people in trouble when they start thinking about actually making risk decisions for their computers. And of course, if I took a computer and put it in cement and put it in a deep hole and bury it, I can still dig up the hole and go get it and turn it on. So there's all different variations on that. But it's, again, it sends the wrong message, I think, of a hopelessness and why we really need more risk management with that analogy. Viruses, we've had viruses as long as we've had computers and when they were transferred on floppy disks. Post-COVID, post-vaccines, you know, this isn't more interesting. The whole world knows about ransomware and you don't really need an analogy to talk about, you know, hostile malicious software on your computer. And we, for the most part, you know, these things are not spreading. I mean, we had some big outbreaks, you know, a couple years ago, but for the most part, you know, the viruses are more watering hole. You're infected a site and you're getting the malicious software that way versus something there that it can get into your computer. Cause most people who are attacking a network are going to live off the land. They're going to actually be opportunistic about how they spread versus a virus, which, you know, spreads into every type of computer that it can get. So again, this one's a little dated as well. It's an interesting thing. But then you get into these analogies. Well, maybe antivirus is your vaccine. And then you can get into all these conspiracy theories. Well, do vaccines work? Do the antivirus works? And it can take you down a rabbit hole, pretty quick. Now, another one that I've seen a lot for people testifying before Congress about cybersecurity and anybody who's got the pew pew maps looking at the internet, is that, you know, defending the nation from a nation state attacks from overseas is a lot like Star Wars, where you can shoot down missiles. And, you know, if a missile was coming to the United States, of course, we want to shoot that down. But why can't we do the same thing with a packet? Now, I do believe we can do things as a nation to kind of protect and inspect, you know, the traffic coming into our sovereign, you know, computers and nation state. But a missile is a physical thing, and it's going to destroy physical things. And if somebody shoots a missile at the United States, that's a very, very clear act of war. And if somebody sends a packet to us that could be used for reconnaissance, could be a precursor to an attack, those rules are still being written. And even though it's 2023, and I've mentioned that several times in this video, I kind of think if we look back at this video 5 years from now, even my comments are probably going to be kind of dated. So I've never really liked the idea that the pew-pew maps of attacks on the internet sort of give reason to, like, hey, maybe we can stop those attacks. Because, you know, one of the big fallacies with those pew-pew maps is that, you know, the attacks already happened. For somebody to put up a map of a packet going from point A to point B, it's already there. That's sort of like drafting, you know, showing the missiles that are inbound after they've already hit the city. So it's not really a decent analogy. Now, another one that I think is also a misnomer for the physical realm is this concept of attack surface management. And it's the kind of thing we say to when we really should be saying we're reducing risk. And, you know, if you think about your attack surface, you know, a smaller target is probably a more stealthy target. It presents, you know, less of an attack, so to speak. But the reality is these things just don't hold up. Like Godzilla has a giant attack surface, and, you know, you're not going to beat him. So he's not going to be worried about reducing his attack surface. Of course, I got an example here where I have a city, you know, and it's got a shield. And if you're into science fiction, yeah, that's a pretty big attack surface, but it's shielded pretty well. So a lot of times we use that term attack surface management, attack surface minimization to kind of show a reduction in risk. But the reality is the attack surface is still there. It's just the points that you want to go after are a lot smaller. Now, the last thing I'm going to talk about is, you know, this concept of the internet fireman. There's some folks out there working this every day. But for the most part, you know, the fireman has all sorts of proactive defenses. And, you know, there's laws that pass that say homes have to have smoke alarms. People do fire drills before they go into school when you get off the bus. There's a whole sort of ecosystem that our line of defense against fires is not waiting to have a fire and then calling the fire department. There's this huge ecosystem where literally the whole nation, including the insurance companies, are bought into that. We are simply not there with cybersecurity. Cybersecurity, we have the illusion of this, but we really don't, right? Cyber insurance is not really changing the game when it comes to ransomware. We are not forced to buy products that actually make sense. There's no consensus. Like there's no smoke alarm equivalent of, you know, for networks. Everybody's network is very different. So a lot of times people describe themselves as these internet firemen, but I think it brings forth a lot of other connotations that maybe we should be aspiring to as an industry, but it's not necessarily an analogy that you want to live with folks out there when. Actually, I think the situation's a lot worse. I mean, most of our houses don't have smoke alarms, would be how I would say the internet is right now. All right. If you enjoyed this, you want to see more videos like this, let me know in the comments below. Subscribe to the channel. You can always engage us over on LinkedIn. Request more videos. Once again, I'm Ron Gula, and thanks for watching.